As we know, earthquakes are one of the most unpredictable activity of the natural disaster. Yet despite their destructive vibration forces, they can lead to a huge costly damage and mass loss of life. There are 1 million earthquakes or millions of earthquakes in a year occurring everywhere around the world, but there's not really need to worry about because most of them are silently active, meaning their magnitude scales mostly are magnitude 2.0 below.
Within my fresh memory, there are two major seismic activity occurred on Luzon Island in the Philippines with a moment magnitude scale of 6.3 and 6.1, and I also felt that too. But the good news is it was not felt so strong, meaning their scale of the surface is likely at magnitude 1 to 4. Because the depth of the quake is likely at 177 kilometers deep below the crust, or 16 Marianas Trench as you can see here on the formula, from top to bottom, or 20 Mount Everest, which is 29,029 feet standing to each other.
But the question is, how strong the earthquake can be? But the first on the list was back on 2010 in Haiti, in the specific place of Port-au-Prince, the capital of the state, where a magnitude 7.0 earthquake hits on January 12, 2010 at 4:53 p.m. in Eastern Time Zone. After the quake, the tsunami warnings was issued for the near coast, but it was quickly cancelled. According to Wikipedia, nearly 2 weeks later, it was reported on the beach of the small fishing town of Petit Paradis was hit by a localized tsunami shortly after the earthquake, probably as a result of an underwater slide. And this was later confirmed by researchers. The quake was so powerful enough because it was only 13 kilometers deep and killed about 100,000 to 300,000 people, making it one of the deadliest earthquakes on record. The second thing is, that killing magnitude held on Haiti was no match on the earthquake happened back in 1990 in Luzon Island, the Philippines still. At July 16 and 4 p.m. also, a 25 kilometer deep magnitude 7.8 earthquake shook the northernmost part of the island, specifically at its epicenter was near town of Rizal in Nueva, Ecija. It was so strong that intensity 9 was felt by thousands of people, damaging 20,000 square kilometers and killing 1,621 people and collapsing 28 to 50 buildings. The quake also produced a 125 kilometer rupture, or about 25% longer than the West Valley Fault. 1 year later after the earthquake, on June 15, 1991, an ultra-Palinian eruption of Mount Pinatubo produced a second largest terrestrial eruption in history, measuring its volcanic explosivity index to 6. The ash cloud produced an unbelievably 10 billion tons of magma and 20 million tons of sulfur dioxide, causing the global temperature to degrade by 0.5 degrees Celsius. That time, it was followed by a storm named Yunya, making the ash cloud in Lahars more lethal and deadly. The eruption receded the elevation of the volcano by 850 feet, before it was 5,725 feet. Finally, about 800 people were killed, 10,000 people were homeless, and 30 to 70 million were affected by an ash cloud Southeast Asia. These quakes are seem to be normal to us, but there is more powerful on the previous records I've mentioned, which is called a megathrust earthquake. Comparing on the tectonic earthquakes, a megathrust earthquake happens on the subduction zones when the diving oceanic crust stucks on the continental crust, creating a pressure between the plates. When too much pressure is filled up, the lock releases, and the megathrust earthquake is born, or usually when they exceed at magnitude 9.0. These colossal quakes can devastate a huge cities, especially with a poor economic status. An example of the megathrust earthquake goes back on February 27, 2010, when a massive earthquake struck here at this point, which mostly the city of Santiago, Valparaiso, and other cities of Argentina, just 46 days after the deadly earthquake struck in Haiti. The tremor was measured at magnitude 8.8 and 45 kilometers deep, resulting in a devastating tsunami, killing 525 people. For comparison, the 2010 earthquake in Haiti with a magnitude 7.0 released only a 500th of its energy, if compared to the largest thermonuclear bomb ever detonated, which released at 50 million tons of TNT, while the magnitude 8.8 releases an unbelievably 15.8 gigatons of TNT, or 31 quadrillion 600 billion pounds. To put that in perspective, about 300 of the largest thermonuclear bombs ever built you need to get the whopping amount of energy. If you ever intend to put that situation in the country of Haiti, which is 13 kilometers deep also, the damage would be 50 times and 95% of the structures will turn into small pieces of pebbles, and the death toll would reach 10 times the death toll of the 1556 Shanxi earthquake, the deadliest earthquake ever recorded.
But still, there is much even stronger than this that if you dare to know. That distinction goes back on Sumatra in 2004, when a huge earthquake struck here at this point, measuring at 9.3 on the Richter scale, creating a tsunami of 100 feet tall. According to Real Life Lore on his video, how big do tsunamis get? The height of the tsunamis equals to 17 people stacking on top of each other. This short animation shows that the traveling of the tsunami slamming 95% of all coastal countries you can see here on this video, and also slammed the coast traveling up to 2 kilometers, especially the country of India.
The tsunami traveled and reached up to the Philippine coastlines, but it doesn't deal any damage because it reached the surface in a dwarf size. Most of their Christmas vacation turned into a catastrophic memory of this colossal disaster. For summarization, about 230,000 people died on two tsunamis, mostly in India, because of no tsunami warning system. But this one is the strongest, largest, and the most powerful earthquake in history back on Chile in 1960 of May 10. This quake produced a terrifying magnitude scale of 9.5, compared to the 2010 earthquake, about 5 times bigger than the magnitude 8.8, and release a devastating energy of 11 times stronger. If you're ever to put this in Haiti, it would kill 30 times the death toll of the 1556 Shanxi earthquake, and 124% of all structures in Haiti will turn into, instead, a small grain of sand. Why these quakes are so powerful? Are there any possibilities for them to reach a magnitude 10 or higher? There's no specific answer for that. But did you know that there are 450 volcanoes are circling around the Pacific Plate, which this, a highlighted area, is called a ring of fire, where powerful quakes and huge volcanoes occurred, and still there are on the future threats like these two major fault lines. The first one is the San Andreas Fault that may trigger a magnitude 7 or higher earthquake that will damage about $200 billion of damage and 1,800 deaths if not well prepared, or a magnitude 7.2 earthquake that will struck here in Manila that will kill 35,000 to 120,000 people, damaging $60 billion. We are extremely surrounded by these freaking quakes, but if you are well prepared, you can assure your life to another generation. Thank you for watching my first narrative video. I would like to apologize for the sound quality because I recorded it in a different environment conditions. Please like and comment your reactions and what should I improve on my next video. Please hit the subscribe button and the bell so you won't miss our next topic. And also, don't forget to donate on my PayPal. Any amount are the signs of your support. You can help me reach my first milestone. Thank you again, guys, and see you on Monday in August 28th.